Don't know.
Hello, big brother. You alright?
Now, whether yesterday morning the blow fell in the very shape.
Hey, how are you? Alright?
Wagwan, Big B. What you saying? You alright, yeah?
It is not Big B. It is Big Brother.
Shut your mouth, man. I call you what I like, cuz about Big. What? Your name's Big B, man. Relax yourself, blood.
How are you feeling today?
Feeling? Oh, God.
To be honest with you, I just wanted to come in here and sit down and get some rest and some relaxation because, you know, it's a crazy house out there.
It's been, I've been in here for a little while now, starting to suss out the people, you know, like getting to know them and that.
Yeah, it's been really nice. I miss my kids, of course. I do miss them. I love you. Mummy loves ya.
So you say I've been in here for what, like a week or something now, like trying to pattern up the girls and that Roxy's a waste girl. Trying to do a little something with that, but she's a bit mad still. Like, it reminds me of my baby mum, you get me?
What seems to be the problem?
What do you mean, what's the problem, bro? So dumb. I hate this place, you know what I'm saying? Too many white people in here, bro. Everyone's talking, I don't understand what they're saying, bro. You know what I'm saying? Where is the equal opportunity, bro? You bring Hardeep Singh in here. What's he gonna do to me, bro? You acting like me and Hardeep are gonna get on, bro. He's an English Asian, bro. He doesn't speak the same way I do, you understand? I'm gonna punch up people in this place. I swear to God, big brother.
What do you make of the Jermaine Pennant situation?
Well, to be honest with you, it's ridiculous. I'll shut my book for this one.
Apparently, he's got a wife at home and a child, and he's doing things like sending messages to Chloe.
He's talking to next girl, sending her messages through the makeup thing, bruv. Opening up, saying, I like you. What do you mean you like her, bruv?
Obviously, Jermaine's lying to her and saying, oh, yeah, man, ain't got no girl. Shut your mouth, man. You're married, blood. Don't lie to a man like that, you get me?
He's a very strange young man.
To be fair, I get along with Jermaine Pennant a lot, you know, being as he was a previous football player and I used to do a bit of coaching back in my day.
He wasn't making it very apparent that he had a young lady outside. He did say, he declared before that he had somebody, but not really a wife. And then he dropped the bombshell saying that he was married with a child as well, so.
I think that's a bit cheating, a bit nasty, but that's what I'm about, you know, I've had seven wives, I've cheated on all of them. So I kind of see where he's coming from and that's how we've made a little bond, a little connection.
You scumbag. I don't even want to talk to Jermaine. I don't even want to stand near him. He's in the same bedroom as me. Like, I'm sharing a bedroom with a scumbag? Are you crazy? Last time I did that, my husband was in jail, so.
How can you go and do that, bruv? You got a nice wife at home. Nice gory, bruv, buff thing. And you in here with this Chloe, 17 years of age, underage thing, bruv. What's wrong with you, bruv? You played for Arsenal. That's why your brain has gone crazy, bruv.
Man made my girl leave, you know? Cause me and Chloe, we had something, you get me? Sly eye contact and that. Man was reaching that from the side. Two twos, I caught a little eyesight. I knew she was on, man, fam. You can't ignore the swag, you get me, Big B? Obviously, bottles and that, you get me?
I don't think his morals are in the right place as far as a man's concerned. He's no human being, but it's just what it is.
Them things happen, you get me? Like, certain man don't know Wagwan. He don't realize how many cameras are in the building.
I don't want to speak to Jermaine. I don't want to know him. I don't want to touch him. I don't want to smell him. I don't want anything to do with Jermaine.
How do you think Jermaine's wife feels?
She's probably crazy as well, bro. Poor thing. She's sitting on watching the telly, bro, thinking, oh my God, Jermaine, what are you doing to me? Why are you doing this? We have children. We happily in love, marriage, everything. Went to the Maldives, flew together. Went inside the water, you know what I'm saying? Went on the dinghy thing, the jet ski.
I hope his wife is watching. If you're watching, sweetie, I hope you're not crying and you're strong enough as an independent woman to listen to Beyonce and make a life for yourself. Because you see that guy in there? He's a scumbag.
I'm not gonna lie to you. I don't wanna talk to Jermaine. He's pissed man off, bruv. Swear to God, Gus May, if I see Jermaine outside of the Big Brother house, I'm gonna give him one patak in his face, bruv.
But all I'm saying is, I'm upholding my end of the deal, and I'm being as good as I can, because I've been tempted so many times to touch Dan Osborne's ass, but I won't do it, so.
What are your feelings on Dan Osborne?
So, sorry, I'm just really engaged. Feelings on Dan Osborne. Dan Osborne flexing the chest every day.
Every single morning that I wake up, he's in my face, you know what I mean?
Prancing around with his naked body and it's getting on my nerves because I'm getting turned on.
He's always half naked, you know, and he's making us feel a little bit insecure and that about me body. I know I've got a bit of a derby going on and that, my belly's not the best. My face don't look all that and all, but he's a proper, like, heartthrob. Do you know what I mean?
Big brother, basically, I've got a massive crush on him, which my husband does know about. But it gets harder every day because, obviously, I'll sit there and watch him come out the shower half naked.
Sick and tired of seeing Dan Osborne running around half naked.
Dan Osborne is here, flexing the muscle, doing all this madness. He's not touching any girls, bruv. Gabby's putting it on him, bruv. Trying to bang him. He's not having his good, respectful man.
But yet there isn't much in the brain. It's very full here, but going upwards, it's very empty.
And every time I'm walking about with my top off and that, Dan stands next to me with his top off. Just makes me feel proper awkward and that, and makes me feel sad. And I think, like, my wife's probably watching this from the outside, wishing that she had someone like Dan. Do you know what I mean? So,
you know, I think we should leave those sort of things to the bedroom. If your wife is wondering what there is, there you go.
His body's amazing, his butt's great, his packs are good, his pecs are good. He can make him dance, like, left and right, left and right.
He does annoy me sometimes, because he doesn't really look into my eyes, and I like looking into guys' eyes so I can see what they feel. But he's very, like, he's like a closed book.
His hair is really nice, he smells good. The only thing letting Dan down is his breath. Stinks like lamb shit. Like, it's really horrible, and I don't really like to sit next to him for too long.
Dan Osborne's alright, still, man's got bare tats. But he's a waste man, like, he thinks he's bad, but he's a proper waste man.
Maybe we might, I don't know, have a kiss or maybe some sex. I don't really know, big brother. You're so nasty. Get away. You're so nasty.
But yet, who am I to complain? I'm only 75, so I wouldn't get my body out if you paid me.
It's a bit annoying, really, but I do really have a crush on Dan Osborne.
Ardeep, on the other end, when I stand next to him, I probably look like someone like, you know, James Bond.
Hardeep is cooking food, burning everything, bruv. He said to me, you want some lamb korai? I said, do me some lamb korai. Come out dead, bruv. What's happening in here, bruv?
Oh, he bugs me so much. He's overweight, he's too airy, and he smells. I can't deal with him. Every single time he says something to me, I ain't got a clue what he's saying. It's too posh.
Hardeep, talking a load of crap, to be honest with you. So I like to put my head into my books and just read nice and slowly.
Hardeep, oh my god, he stinks. Hardeep has not showered in like 3 days. I don't know what's his problem, but I'm just not entertained, Big Brother. And I'm really getting depressed in here.
What's your opinion on Roxanne and Ryan?
Roxy is crazy as shit. I thought I was crazy, but oh my god, she's so crazy.
Roxy's a bit mad.
She's mentally charged, bruv. Something wrong with her brain. She's dancing and touching up this next man's bruv, but she's got husband on that side.
Now Ryan, you, hey, keep him away from me, man. I don't like him.
Ryan, I don't really know. I haven't sussed him out yet. He's kind of tricky. I did see him punch up Roxanne, which did scare me a little bit because I don't like violence.
Bit of a geezer once again. He done something the other day which I don't mind. A bit of, you know, letting the women know that we're the strongest. He's gone and had a little sparring match with Roxy there.
Mad things, Ryan as well, punching up Roxanne. I like that, bruv. Sometimes you got to smack the ladies to let them know what's happening, you know what I'm saying?
It wasn't really a punch-up, it was more like a Mike Tyson on the bag sort of smack-up.
She shit herself, started crying and that. I think it was a bit over, you know, exaggerated and that, but...
She's a crazy little tartar and all, Roxy. Don't know whether she's coming or going, trying to bang Ben. Then she's moving on to Dan. Don't touch my man, Jesus Christ.
You can leave the diary room now.
Are you dumb?
Maybe I don't want to leave. What do you mean I'm free to leave, bro? Am I free to leave the whole building?
Calm down. We are just asking you to leave.
For what? I don't understand, man. What are you trying to say, though? Like, I don't understand. Explain a bit more. Like, you're trying to tell man to calm down. For what reason, Big B?
May we kindly ask you to leave the diary room?
Please, can I just finish the bottom of this page? It's amazing.
Big Brother thinks you are being aggressive.
Fam, you man ain't seen aggressive, rude boy. Step out the camera thing, man. I know you're in there, you know, bruv. You think I'm scared of you, but if you're a bad man, yeah, come out the camera right now if you're done. If you're built like that, big brother.
The only other thing I will say is Roxanne took a shit the other day in the toilet and it stunk. So we can get some of that Febreze stuff so I can make it smell fresher. I'd appreciate that, big brother.
It also is my custom, he said, smiling in the most pleasant fashion until his eyes were just two little shining slits amid the white grease.
But tell him, man, to calm down. Watch yourself through, boy, man. You don't know me. You don't know who I am, blood.
These chairs are more comfortable, by the way, than the ones indoors. So if you'd like to change them, that would be much appreciated.
Please may you leave the diary room.
Shut your mouth, man. I'll leave the diary room, what? I'll leave the diary room, what? Oh, that's his photo at the camera, you know.
Say, big brother, I'm going outside. Hot tub is calling us, isn't it? Dan Osborne, looking buff. Come on, bro. See you later, big brother.
See you later, big B.
Cheers, big brother.
See you later, big brother.
I said, Jesus Christ. Okay, big brother, thank you so much. Thank you. Bye-bye.
It's the last time I come in here, you know. Waste, man. What should I do, yeah? Pussy, oh. No, bun that, man. Big brother's an idiot, bruv.